You know, when it comes down to relationships, the relationships that we have.
It don't grasp it because positive energy is good energy. And good energy gives off good vibes. When you throw it that way, it's going to get you received. Remember now, because the negative energy was created, so is the positive energy. Even though there's a balance right there, it's not a natural balance for you. Well, yeah, there's a natural order of negative and positive, but that's day and night. Okay? Those are the negative and the positive. That's in balance, like yin and yang. But our relationships aren't supposed to be that way. You see what I'm talking about? Because our relationships go, it's not built that way. You know what I'm saying? Everything's supposed to be in the positive direction, so we can have the genesis of that. With each other, with the universe, with the planet, with everything. You feel me? And that's why, you know, like I say, it's a road I'm traveling on. And when I decided to travel this road, I had to look at everything, man, I had to throw that to Mom. I said, Mom, I said, do you understand why? You probably don't understand why, but you're gonna tell me, well, I don't feel like it. So I'm not asking how you felt. I'm telling you about it. See, I had to put it like this is how I had to put it. I had to go through a series of stories to tell her about this unconditional covenant. See, I use words that connect with the Bible, so she was able to comprehend what I'm saying, even from using the God and Jesus standpoint. But I mean, I put it that way. You can't deny it that way, too, because I'm well-versed in the story, so I understand the context behind it. And this is what I said. I made a covenant with God concerning that person. And see, he takes covenants very seriously. Now, the covenant ain't got nothing to do with that person. The covenant got to do with what you made with the creator of the universe. That you're going to be unconditional. You see what I'm talking about?
To the end.
To the very end. And you're held accountable for that. Yeah. And don't let nobody tell you that you need to leave it. Don't let nobody tell you it's not worthy. Don't let nobody tell you it's not worth it. Don't let nobody tell you that you're being used. Don't you feel like you're being used? Because whatever happens to you, it's not about you anyway. It's about the covenant.
I struggle with that so much every day.
Wow.
It's like it's at a point right now where it's like you be doing, like you know what's supposed to be going on, but it's like, yeah, it's such a hard struggle, man. You know what I'm saying?
It ain't this game.
Yeah.
There's nobody playing this game. Mm-hmm. He's been in the dark. How many years, man?
Long as I've been alive.
Okay. But this game, your mom, how many people you actually know that's doing it? Seriously.
Talking it like this.
I mean, really trying to walk the unconditional road.
I can't say that there are any. You know, I mean, because there always seems to be some kind of, you know, condition. Something.
What are you saying?
You know, it just seems to be like,
it just always seems to be like some kind of, it's not one condition, you know what I'm saying? It's always a strange attacks, like some kind of, like, when you listen to the commercials, it's like the gibberish after the commercial that they say, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, no, this shit over. Yeah. You know, the disclaimer.
Yeah, the disclaimer.
See? Yeah. Oh. Yeah. See, listen, dude, wait a minute. Hey, that's a valid thing. Yeah. Look, I guess what I really want to see in my lifetime, there's a moment where everything everything around me is unconditional. That would be that would be the purest moment in my entire life. If everything around me was unconditional. Do you know how pure that moment would be? If you got to that moment in your life, then you could leave.
Yeah.
You could actually leave.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. When I say leave,
I think once you do get to that point,
you ascend it.
You have ascended.
You have ascended.
Yeah. For real.
Okay, wait a minute. See, because you know that's what we're talking about.
Yeah.
Ascension. Yeah. See, because when a being ascends, it ascends to something that's. Because you now, all the energy around you is in agreement. Yeah. And it creates something totally brand new. But to talk about this and to walk that path is exactly where when we talk about creation and talk about where we talk about Him and what He really is, Bo, that is what we're talking about. And when we talk about the great one, the great I am, you know, God, Allah, Amdu Allah, Allahu Akbar, you know, Buddha,
whatever.
Yeah. I mean, it doesn't matter where you are on this planet, what language you speak. Yeah. It's only one thing that we're talking about.
Right.
And nobody knows what it looks like.
Right.
Because we can't look at it from the physical eye.
Right.
We're talking about the thing that created the cosmos.
Right.
Not the universe, but the cosmos. And the cosmos is vast.
Right.
We in the billionth of a lifetime of living in energy could never travel the cosmos.
No, not in the earth, not a human lifetime.
Yeah. But see, we're not talking. But see, we're talking about dimensions.
Right.
See, but the thing here's the part that most people miss. Now look at
me. Hey, also, I want to talk about dimensions. But if you're going to talk about traveling across the cosmos, like you have to consider like changing form as well.
Well,
you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like you wouldn't be able to do that
in this
form.
Okay, now watch where this conversation is going to go. Watch which way it's going to turn now. Here we go. You know we do that, right?
So,
huh?
I mean, yeah.
You want to know how we do that?
You know exactly. Yeah.
Every time you go to sleep. You didn't know that?
Yeah.
You want to know how? Let me explain it to you. Okay, first of all, your physical body, it has to regenerate itself. But your consciousness doesn't. Your consciousness never goes to sleep. That's the energy.
Right.
Your consciousness is the energy of you.
Right, it's still there.
The body has to rest.
Yeah.
The consciousness never sleeps. It can leave.
Yeah.
While your body's... Your consciousness is going into other dimensions. They exist.
Yeah.
Don't think, do you think, see here's the part that really, really kind of gets people, okay, I can take you there now. You want to go there?
Come in.
Okay, I'm going to take you there. See, what makes you think that your dreams are reality, and this isn't a dream.
Right.
Because it's all reality, because your conscious never sleeps.
Right.
This is just a moment in another dimension.
Right.
You live in other dimensions.
Right.
You want to hear something? You remember when, you know, when you sit there, you make a decision to do this or do that? You create another dimension. Because if you do something, it creates a dimension going that way.
Right.
That's an existence.
Right.
You've thought about if I take these steps toward this way, or if I take these steps toward this way, it's going to cause a dimension going heading this way. And these are the causes and reactions that come with that dimension. But if I take a negative, I take this dimension, it causes these things. If I smoke crack, I become hooked on crack. That's a dimension. If I smoke reefer, I get high. That's a dimension. If I don't smoke reefer, I'm in this dimension.
Right.
If I drink alcohol, I'm in that dimension.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
We alter our physical state,
right,
which alters the dimension.
Right. Right.
From its natural state.
Right. Right.
But we actually, our conscious never dies.
I give to you everything I have, but it never seems enough, no, no. No matter what I do, it's never good enough for you. try to find out what it is I can do to make it through to you. But if not for me to understand, it's got to trip me.
Unconditional
love is what I'm looking for.
Something unconditional.
Trying to find that one thing that will always last forevermore.
Unconditional.
Maybe it's gonna be that time, and I'm gonna have to understand that I'm. Walk this path alone, yes.
Unconditional.
I won't give up my. I won't give in time. I'm always trying to find. Unconditional, like the sun above. That's how I know it's gotta be gotta be unconditional for me. Be part of things. Just keep holding on to what you know is true. But you can be unconditional to you. Be true to yourself.